Today's topic is product of connected spaces. Earlier, we have proved that product of two connected spaces is a connected space. Today, we will discuss the product of any arbitrary collection of connected spaces. And in fact, we shall show that connectedness is a product invariant property for general product spaces also. Before coming to the main theorem, recall that if XT and YV are topological spaces, then for X in X, singleton X cross Y is homeomorphic to Y. We have proved this result earlier. Similarly, we can show that for an arbitrary collection of topological spaces, X lambda, T lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda, the subset Cartesian product of Y lambdas, where Y lambda is equal to X lambda for all lambda is equal to mu 1, mu 2 up to mu n, and Y lambda is equal to singleton X lambda for each lambda other than mu 1, mu 2 up to mu n of the product space is homeomorphic to the Cartesian product of X mu 1, X mu 2 up to X mu n. We shall make use of this result in the main theorem. Now we shall prove the theorem, which states that at X lambda, T lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda, be an arbitrary collection of topological spaces, and let X is equal to Cartesian product of X lambdas, let T be the product topology on X, then XT is connected if and only if each coordinate space is connected. Let us prove this theorem. Let XT be connected, product space is connected, then we have to prove that each coordinate space is connected. As we know that projection pi lambda from X to X lambda is continuous and on to for each lambda in capital lambda. We have proved this result, and we also know that the continuous image of a connected space is connected. So X lambda here is continuous image of connected space X. So each X lambda is connected, and so each, we can say that each coordinate space is connected. Conversely, let each coordinate space X lambda T lambda be connected, then we have to show that the product space X T is connected. Let A is equal to A lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda, be a fixed point of X which belongs to a component C of X. A component C of X, that is a maximal connected subset C of X, and A belongs to this C. We shall show that every point of X belongs to C. If each point of X will be in C, then X will be contained in C, but since C is a subset of X, then we must have C is equal to X in C, and since C is connected, so X will be connected. We know that the subset A, Cartesian product of Y lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda of X, where Y lambda is equal to X lambda, for lambda is equal to mu 1, mu 2 up to mu n, and Y lambda is equal to A lambda, singleton A lambda, for all lambda other than mu 1, mu 2 up to mu n, is homeomorphic to X mu 1 cross X mu 2 up to cross X mu n. A is homeomorphic to this. As the product of a finite number of connected spaces is connected, as we know that product of any two connected spaces is connected, so similarly we can prove that product of any finite number of connected spaces is connected. So this space X mu 1 cross X mu 2 cross up to cross X mu n is connected. Since each x mu 1, x mu 2 up to x mu n is connected, so their product is also connected. As connectedness is a topological property. Topological property means homeomorphic image of a connected space is always connected. And since A is homeomorphic to Cartesian product of x mu 1, x mu 2 up to x mu n, and since this is connected, so being homeomorphic image of this connected space, A is also connected. We note that A contains A is equal to A lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda. Since y lambda is equal to A lambda for all lambda not equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n, and for all lambda is equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n, y lambda is equal to x lambda. So all remaining coordinates will be covered in x lambda. And so this A is contained in capital A. As A is a connected subset containing A, and C is a connected subset containing A. So we have two connected sets, and they are not disjoint. So their union is connected. C union A is a connected subset of X containing C, but as C is maximal connected, so we must have C union A is equal to C. It follows that A is contained in C. Next, let X be, X is equal to X lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda, be a point of X. We shall show that each neighborhood of X contains a point of A. So we take some neighborhood, let Cartesian product G lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda, be an arbitrary basic open set in X containing X, where G lambda is open in X lambda, and G lambda is equal to X lambda for each lambda other than mu 1, mu 2 up to mu n. Then consider the point Z. Z lambda, lambda belongs to capital lambda, where Z lambda is equal to A lambda for all lambda different from mu 1, mu 2 up to mu n. And Z lambda is equal to X lambda for lambda is equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n. Then this Z belongs to A, because for all lambda not equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n, Z lambda is equal to A lambda. And here we have Y lambda is equal to singleton A lambda for all lambda not equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n. And for the remaining coordinates, we have coordinate sets equal to X lambda. So this Z belongs to A. And we also note that this point Z also belongs to this Cartesian product of G lambda, because for all lambda not equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n, we have X lambdas, and we have X lambda in which this A lambda always belongs. And for all Z lambda, for lambda is equal to mu 1, mu 2, mu n, we have X lambdas, and in which we have here G mu 1, G mu 2, G mu n. Here we know that X belongs to G mu, X mu 1 belongs to G mu 1, X mu 2 belongs to G mu 2, up to X mu n belongs to G mu. So this Z belongs to Cartesian product of G lambda, whereby each neighborhood of X contains a point of A. Here Z belongs to A, and we have shown that Z belongs to this open set. So this is any open neighborhood of X. So every neighborhood of X contains a point of A. And since A is contained in C, so every neighborhood of X contains a point of C. So we can say that X belongs to the closure of C. Since every neighborhood of X contains a point of C, so X belongs to the closure of C. As C is a component, so C is always a closed set, so C is equal to closure of C. And so X belongs to C. As X is an arbitrary point of X, so we can say that every point of X is contained in C, so X is contained in C. But we know that C is a maximal connected subset of X, so C is contained in X, so we have C is equal to X. As C is connected, so X is connected, and so we have shown that if coordinate spaces are connected, then their protected space is also connected. Thank you.